But who was impersonating them? And where was Lee Harvey Oswald? Around 12:15, on her way out of the building to see the motorcade, Secretary Carolyn Arnold sees Oswald in the second floor snack room, where he said he went for a Coke.
He was in a booth on the right side of the room. He was by himself, as usual, appeared to be having his lunch. I didn't speak to him, but I recognized him clearly.
At the same time, Bonnie Ray Williams is supposedly eating his chicken lunch in the sixth floor. He's there until 12:15, maybe 12:20. He sees nobody. Arnold Rowland's down the street. He's looking up. He sees two men in the sixth floor window, presumably after Bonnie Ray Williams had finished his lunch and left.
John Powell, the prisoner on the sixth floor of the Dallas County Jail, sees them.
Quite a few of us guys saw them. Everybody was hollering and yelling and all that. We thought they were security guys.
If Oswald was the assassin, he was certainly pretty nonchalant about moving himself into position. Later, he told Dallas police he was in the second floor snack room, probably told to wait there by his handler for a phone call. But the phone call never came. A maximum 90 seconds after Kennedy is shot, patrolman Marion Baker runs into Oswald in that second floor lunchroom.
Hey, you! Do you know this man? Is he an employee?
Yes, he is. The president's been shot.
But what the Warren Commission would have us believe is that after firing three bolt-action shots in 5.6 seconds, Oswald then leaves three cartridges neatly side by side in the firing nest, wipes the rifle clear of fingerprints, stashes the rifle on the other side of the loft, sprints down five flights of stairs past witnesses Victoria Adams and Sandra Stiles, who never see him. He shows up cool and calm on the second floor in front of patrolman Baker. All this within a maximum of 90 seconds of the shooting.
Hey, you! Do you know this man? Is he an employee?
Yes, he is. The president's been shot.
Is he out of breath? According to Baker, absolutely not. Assuming he is the sole assassin, Oswald is now free to escape from the building. The longer he delays, the more chance the building will be sealed by police. Is he guilty? Does he walk out the nearest staircase? No. He buys a Coke, and at a slow pace, spotted by Mrs. Reed on the second floor, he strolls out the more distant front exit, where the cops have gathered. Oddly, considering that three shots have been fired from there, nobody seals the book depository for 10 more minutes. Oswald slips out, as do several other employees. Of course, when he realized something had gone wrong and the president had been killed, he knew there was a problem. He may have even known he was the patsy. An intuition, maybe. The president killed in spite of his warning. The phone call that never came. Perhaps fear now came to Oswald for the very first time.